Yeah, in this class, we are discussing a few more problems based on suppose Q of x means right-hand side function of a given a differential equation with a constant coefficient. Suppose the function is a trigonometric function, especially only two functions are sine and cosine function. How to find out pi? We are looking to a few more problems in this class, okay? Now, solve the following differential equation that solve. Solve the following differential equations. Okay. And not necessary to write in all the problems, solve like that. Okay. Now, today first problem, y double dash plus 9y equals cos 2x into cos x. Yeah. Now, already I told whenever they're given the way of expressing derivative, either may be write dy by dx or you have to write y1 or you have to write y dash. Suppose you express like that y1 or y dash, how can you know that which one is independent variable? Dependent variable is fine. Why? What is a independent variable? I told number of times, you look into the right hand side for q of x. What's a variable involved? Based on that, we treated that's an independent variable. Means y double dash means second derivative with respect to x only. Because in the right hand side, involving the variable are nothing but x. Therefore, independent variable in this problem is x. Therefore, first you have to take what's a given in the problem. The given is y double dash plus 9y equal to cos 2x into cos x. Now, I express in terms of differential operator d square y plus 9y equal to now cos 2x into cos x. Now, here observe carefully in the right hand side, it's a product of two trigonometric functions. We don't know the product of two trigonometric functions, how to find out pi. Only we discuss in the last class how to find out pi for cos or sine, which is a product of two functions. You know how to convert product of two functions into sum or difference of the two trigonometric functions using transformation formula. Cos A, cos B. What is cos A, cos B? Is nothing but half of cos of A plus B. What is cos of A plus B? And then plus cos of A minus B. Okay. This formula you already studied in diploma course. In spite of that, I am explaining how to convert product of two trigonometric functions, sum or difference of the trigonometric functions using transformation formula. Here, A is equal to 2x. What is my B is equal to x. Therefore, cos 2x into cos x is nothing but half of cos of a plus b. What is a plus b? Is 3x plus cos of 2x minus x. What we get? Cos x. Now, therefore, instead of product of this, what we are going to write? Half of cos 3x plus cos x. I think it's clear why I'm expressing like that. Because we don't know the formula for what is a pi for product of two trigonometric functions. Therefore, with the help of transformation formula, we have to convert into sum or difference of trigonometric function. Once you apply the transformation formula in this problem, we get sum of two trigonometric functions. What are that? Cos and cos 3x and cos x. You know the formula, right? No issue. Now, I move to the next step. Keep y right side d square y plus d square plus 9 into y equals 1 by 2 of cos 3x plus cos x. Okay. I move to next step. First, try to write the auxiliary equation. This is nothing but f of d. Okay. Now, what is my auxiliary equation? Auxiliary equation is replace d by m in f of d and then equal to 0. What we get actually? M square plus 9 equal to 0. That implies m square is a quadratic formula, not necessary to go for synthetic division method. First verify whether it's possible to find out directly or factorize, otherwise you go for quadratic formula. But here possible. Now m is equal to plus or minus root of minus 9. It's nothing but root of minus 9 is nothing but root of minus 1 into root of 9. Root of minus 1, you know that I, this is 3. Therefore, plus or minus 3i. Okay. Plus or minus, what is that actually? 3i. Okay. Plus or minus 3i. Yeah. Means from this, alpha equal to 0, beta is equal to 3. From the fourth case D, what we discussed in the first class of differential equation with constant coefficients, Cf is e power of alpha is 0 into independent variable Cx of C1 cos 3x plus C2 into sin 3x. It's nothing but just only C1 cos 3x plus C2 into sin 3x. Okay. Now move to the next step. How to find out Pi? Yeah, there are two terms. Better to take term by term. Okay. For our convenient. Pi1. What is Pi1? 1 by f of d. What is f of d? D square plus 9. Yeah, d square plus 9. Here, 1 by 2 is a constant. Therefore, I'll keep it outside. Into cos 3x. Okay, fine. 1 by 2. Yeah. Now, I told a number of times this point. Before going to apply the formula for finding Pi for cos or sine, first you observe what's the coefficient of the trigonometry function of x. What's the coefficient of x here? Here, a is equal to 3, right? Here, a is equal to what? 3. Now, what's our condition? Plus or minus ia is nothing but plus or minus ai is a root. Yeah, plus or minus 3a is a root or not, I want to verify. This point you already know that. Before move to the next step, first you have to verify whether plus or minus ia, alpha must be 0, plus or minus ia is a root. Yeah, is here a is equal to 3, plus or minus a is a pair of root of auxiliary equation. Is a pair of root of auxiliary equation, you can't replace d square by minus of a square. Suppose you replace it, what we get denominator is 0. How to proceed now? 1 by 2 into x divided by f dash of d. And then replace d square to minus of a square. Cos 3x. 1 by x by 2. Okay. F dash. What is f dash? 2d. Derivative of, what is my f of d here? F of d is nothing but d square plus 9. What is my f dash of d? F dash of d is nothing but 2d into what actually cos 3x. Yeah, I told in the previous class, d is nothing but differential operator. D is what? Differential operator. 1 by d means integrate. The both differentiation and integration are inverse process. What is 1 by d denotes? Integrate. Integrate which one? Cos 3x. Integration of cos 3x with respect to x is what? Sin 3x divided by 3. What we get? X sin 3x divided by 4 3 is a 12. Yeah. Now, this point, I think you are clear how we get this. 1 by d. What is 1 by d? D is a differential operator. Reciprocal of 1 by d is nothing but 1 by d is nothing but integrate. 1 by d is nothing but integrate. Therefore, what is integration of cos 3x is sin 3x by 3. then 4 3 are 12. Now similarly, I have to find out pi 2. What is pi 2? 1 by d square plus 9. Again, off is a constant into cos x. Okay. Now, 1 by 2. Now, you see here, a is equal to what? 1. Quotient of x is 1. That implies plus r minus I a is what actually? Plus r minus I. It's not a pair of root of auxiliary equation. Therefore, what we are going to do here in the next step is what's the formula? I have to replace d square by minus of a square. Replace d square by minus of a square. What is my a is 1. Therefore, what we get? Minus of a square is minus of 1 square plus 9 into cos x. What we get actually minus 1 minus of 1 square by 1 square is 1 minus 1 plus 9 is 8, 8 2s are 16, 1 by 16 cos x. Don't confuse, this is not minus 1 whole square, minus of 1 square. What we get? 8 2s are 16. Therefore, what is my pi is pi 1 plus pi 2. Nothing, but what is my pi 1 is x sine 3x divided by 12 plus pi 2 is nothing but 1 by 16 cos x. Then I have to write what is our general solution. General solution is y equals cf plus pi. Cf is nothing but c1 cos 3x plus c2 sine 3x. Plus pi, x sin 3x divided by 6, 12, 1 by 16 into cos x. Yeah, this way I have to solve the given differential equation with the constant quotient, that the differential equation is non-homogeneous. Now, why particularly I am taking this problem, especially I want to explain for this part. So, it says whenever having product of two trigonometry functions, how to proceed. First, you have to convert some more difference of the trigonometry functions using transformation formula cos A, cos B, sin A, sin B, sin cos A, sin B, sin A, cos B, like that. Then, definitely from the transformation formula, it's possible I have to convert into some more difference of the two trigonometry functions. And then, as usual, find out CF. Here we get one of a pair of complex root is plus r minus di. While finding a particular integral for trigonometry function, first you pick the value of a. Verify whether plus r minus ia is a pair of root in the auxiliary equation. It's a root, you can't replace d square by minus of a square. What's the formula? X divided by f dash of d, and then replace d square by minus a square. Now, but while finding derivative, we get 1 by d. 1 by d is nothing but what actually integration. D is a differentiation, reciprocal of differentiation is nothing but integrate. You have to integrate cos 3x once with respect to x. And next you have to take second function is cos x. In the cos x, a is 1, therefore plus r minus I is not a pair of root of auxiliary equation. What's the formula? Replace d square by minus of a square. Simplify that. Finally, we get a solution of the given problem. Okay. Now, I am showing entire problem in one screenshot. This is a way to solve the problem. Suppose they are having a product of two trigonometric functions. Okay. Now, move to the next problem. D cube y divided by dx cube plus 2 into d square y by dx square plus dy by dx equals e power of minus x plus sin 2x. Okay. Now, First, we have to express in terms of differential operator. That's very clear. They given a derivative with respect to x. It's nothing but d cube y 2 into d square y plus dy equal to e power minus x plus sin 2x. No issue in the right hand side. First term is in the form of e power of ax. Second term is in the form of sin of ax. Okay. Now and then I have to write it in the form of polynomial d cube plus 2d square plus d into y equals e power of minus x plus sine 2x. Yeah. We get in the form of what actually? F of d. This is my f of d. Yeah, and then I have to write auxiliary equation. Auxiliary equation is replace d by m and in f of d and then equal to 0. See, after writing a polynomial in a auxiliary equation, it's a cubic polynomial, but not necessary to go for synthetic division method. First you observe, whenever having higher order polynomial, first you observe whether it's possible to simplify directly. Simplify, try to reduce to quadratic form. Now is possible, now I take m is outside common factor, what's the remaining m square plus 2m plus 1 must be equal to 0. That implies m equal to 0 and also what is another one, m square plus 2m plus 1 is equal to 0. You already know that this is a standard form, m plus 1 whole square, a square plus 2ab plus b square equal to 0. That implies what are the values are expecting? M is 0, m is equal to minus 1 because it's repeated twice. The m plus 1 whole square can also be written as m plus 1 into m plus 1, therefore repeated twice. And also m is equal to minus 1. We get all three roots are real, but one of the root is repeated twice. Then I have to write carefully what is my CF. CF is nothing but C1 into e power of 0 into x plus C2 into e power of minus 1 into x plus C3 into, yeah, it's a repeated root. What's the formula we are going to use here? Yeah, both M2 and M3 must be same, repeated twice. You're combining these two, this can be written as C2 plus C3 x into e power of minus x. Using case 2, how to write the CF? Suppose they having a real root repeated more than once. And next, try to find out PI for first term and PI for the second term. Okay. PI1 equals 1 by f of d, d cube plus 2d square plus d into e power of minus x. If we want to find out pi for exponential function, first you have to verify what is a. A is equal to minus 1. Observe, a is equal to minus 1 is a root or not? Yeah, I verify in exponential and trigonometric, don't confuse. Exponential I have to verify is a real root. Then trigonometry function I have to verify is in the form of complex root, but we don't want which one? Alpha, real part, only imaginary part. Don't confuse. Just madam is told complex root, there we have to differentiate like that. Not like that. Purely they expecting imaginary part, we don't want real part. That such type of root is there, then has to take care in trigonometry function. Now, a is equal to minus 1 is a double root, right? Is a double root of the auxiliary equation. It's a double root. Therefore, how to proceed now? Now, I have to, you know that is a one of the root means you know is a is equal to a is a one root means what's the formula? X divided by f dash of d and then replace d by a. Then a is two double root, What's the formula? X square divided by f double dash of d, and then replace d by a. Now is a double root. What's the formula here? X square divided by f double dash of d, and then I have to replace d by a. What is d by a? Is minus 1. In this case, what is a? A is equal to minus 1. Then I have to substitute first. What is second derivative? The first derivative of this is f of d. F of d is nothing but, yeah, for your reference, I am writing everything on the board. F of d is equal to d cube plus 2d square plus d. Okay. What is my f dash of d? 3d square plus 4d. Yeah, just like x square, x cube like that. Plus 1. F double dash of d. F double dash of d is 6d. Plus 4. This is the value we are expecting. Okay. Now, once you differentiate twice, what we get actually? Now, this is a thing we are expecting now. 6d plus 4. Yeah. 6d plus 4. F double dash of d. For t is equal to minus 1 e power of minus x. Now I have to replace d by what actually? Minus 1. 6 into minus 1. What we get? Minus 6 plus 4 into e power of minus x. What we get finally? Minus x square by 2 e power of minus x. This is my p of i1. Means particular integral of the first term. We have to differentiate twice, just like x cube, x square, and then replace d by a. Because up to second derivative, if you want to replace here, a is equal, t is equal to minus 1, or if you want to replace d is equal to minus 1, f of t and f dash of t definitely get 0. We don't want infinite value, we are expecting finite value. Now, this is a way I have to find out, suppose it's a double root for the exponential function. Now, keep in mind, if you want to find out pi for exponential, observe the real root. And then, if you want to find out trigonometry function, observe whether they're having complex root. That complex root is in the form of plus or minus ia. We are expecting real part must be 0. Okay, what is my p of i2? It's nothing but 1 by d square, d cube plus 2d square plus d into sine 2x. Here, a is equal to 2. That implies plus or minus ia is nothing but plus or minus 2i. It's not a pair of root of auxiliary equation. Okay, fine. What is our next step? Now here, I have to replace d square by minus of a square. Replace what? Replace d square by minus of a square. What is a square? Is 2 square. But d cube can also be written as d square into d. Okay. Now, therefore, what we get here? D into minus of 2 square. Plus 2 into minus of 2 square plus d. Yeah, this is a one of a different type of problem if I'm considering this. Okay. Now just replace only even power d square. D power of 4 can be written as d square whole square. But whenever having odd power, what I did here, d cube can be written as d square into d. But you can't write d square form, therefore the d, therefore leave it as itself. First I have to simplify. Minus 4d, and then what we get actually here, this is nothing but minus 4 into 2, we get minus 8 plus d sine 2x. Simplify that, what we get actually, minus 3d minus 8 sine 2x. Now, better I have to take minus sign outside, minus of 3d plus 8, 3d plus 8 into sine 2x. Now this is not a solution of sine 2x. Why? Still have a differential operator in the denominator. When we will treat it as a solution, we are expecting, we are not expecting any differential operator either in the numerator or in the denominator. that term we treated as a solution of the corresponding P of trigonometric function and also exponential function. You must be eliminate differential operator in both numerator and denominator. Yes, but still have a in the denominator d. How to eliminate now? Have to do the rationalization. If you want to eliminate means have to replace. If you want to replace the value means at express d in terms of d square. Therefore, what's the possibility here? I go for rationalization. Please try to understand why we are go for rationalization. I want to convert d to d square. Then only is possible I have to replace d square by minus of a square. Therefore, what we are going to do here, I have to do the rationalization, both numerator and denominator, I have to multiply it with, you have a plus b, I have to multiply it with a minus b. Then only we get a square minus b square. 3d minus 8 divided by 3d minus 8 into sine 2x. Now, minus of 3d minus 8 divided by a square, a plus b into a minus b is nothing but a square minus b square. Now, what we get? 9d square, a square, 3d whole square, 9d square minus 64. 8 square is 64. Sine 2. In the next step, I have to replace d by what actually? Minus of a square. What is minus of a square? Minus of 2 square. Okay? Minus 64 into sine 2x. Now, what we get actually? 36. You simplify this. Minus 4, 9s are minus 36 and also minus 64. What we get in the denominator? 100. Minus 100. Already have minus, we get 1 by 100. Simultaneously, I have to take sine 2x in the numerator. Multiplied with first term and second term. Why I have to do that? Just few minutes before I told. You must be eliminate d is in differential operator in both numerator and denominator. For what we are going to do, multiplied with sine 2x minus 8 sine 2x. 1 by 100 of differentiation of what is d stands for? Derivative with respect to x. What is derivative of sine 2x with respect to x? Cos 3 into cos 2x into 2. Yeah. Minus 8 into what is derivative of? It's not, there is no derivative sine 2x only because only just we have multiplied that. Now, what's a common factor? If you want to take common factor, it's 2. 2 by 100 is 50. What's the remaining? 3 cos 2x minus 4 sine 2x. This is nothing but my pi 2. Then you take sum of pi 1 and pi 2. Pi equals Pi1 plus Pi2. Pi1 is nothing but minus x square by 2 e power of minus x plus Pi2 is 1 by 50 into 3 cos 2x minus 4 sin 2x. Now, I have to write what is my general solution. What is my general solution is? General solution is y equals cf plus pi. What is my cf? Oh, you already done in the beginning of the problem. C2 plus c3x into e power of minus x and then minus x square by 2 e power of minus x plus 1 by 50 into 3 cos 2x minus 4 sin 2. Yeah, this is a general solution of the given problem. Now, this is a little bit different what we discussed in the from the last two classes. That's why I discussed in the class this problem in the class. This also problem they given in the model paper, in our question paper in old paper. Now I'm showing this problem. It's not possible to show it the entire problem in one screenshot. Observe carefully here. Yeah, this is a given problem. First, you have to express in terms of the differential operator, and then you write the auxiliary equation by replacing d by m in f of d, and then equal to zero. Solve that, we get three roots. All roots are real, but one of the root is repeated twice. Carefully, with the help of case 2, for the what we discussed in the first class, to write the complementary function, with the help of that, you write it that. And then first you find out pi of e power of minus x. While finding pi of e power of minus x, what we are going to do here, first take the value of a. What's the value of a here? The value of a is nothing but minus 1. Now you already know that in the finding a pi for a trigonometry function, finding a pi for the trigonometry function, we already know that one point, we already familiar with that point. The point is actually take quotient of x in exponential. What's the quotient of x in exponential? Is minus 1. Is a minus 1. Observe carefully whether this minus 1 is a root of the auxiliary equation. Observe the real root. Is minus 1 is a root? Yeah, is a double root of the auxiliary equation. Therefore, what we are going to do here, and to x square and to differentiate the f of t twice and then replace d by minus 1. Why? Because f of t and f dash of t is, once you replace d by minus 1, we get 0 in the denominator. And then simplify that, we get a pi 1. Similarly, move to pi 2. While taking pi 2, observe what's the quotient of x in trigonometry function is 2 plus r minus ia is nothing but plus r minus 2i. Plus r minus 2i is not a verify that whether is a root of auxiliary equation. But plus r minus 2i is not a root of auxiliary equation. Therefore, what we are going to do, replace d square by minus of a square. What is a square? 2 square. But now here, d cube, we can't replace directly. Therefore, at express in terms of d square is nothing but d square into d. Now, at replace first and second term, we can't substitute in the last term. Simplify that, we get a linear form. But I told number of times, we are going to stop to replace this value until we have to eliminate the differential operator in both numerator and denominator. Therefore, still have in the denominator which one? B. Therefore, what we are going to do here, we have to do the rationalization. Why? I need a square minus b square. Therefore, I have to multiply and divide it by a minus b. Automatically, we get a square minus b square. Now, I have to replace d square by minus of a square. Still have a numerator d. Therefore, I have to multiply it with sin 2x with first term and second term. D means derivative with respect to x. Therefore, what we are going to do here, differentiate sin 2x with respect to x is 2 cos 2x. Simplify that. And suppose you take 2 common factor, we get 1 by 15 to 3 cos 2x minus 4 sin 2x. Take that sum is nothing but pi. Y is nothing but, so solve means dependent variable y, independent variable x. We are expecting finally solution of dependent variable in terms of independent variable and also constant. Sometimes maybe get a constant also. Not required, it's not expecting always we get a solution in terms of the constant term also. It depends upon the what type of function they provide in the right hand side. Now this is a way to solve that problem. I'm showing entire problem in two screenshot, but it's not possible to show it in one screenshot. Okay. Yeah. This is a way I have to do it. The next is actually next one, this is, even though before I'm going to wind up that, I'm going to share my e-content notes, you go through that. In this, rarely they're going to ask non-homogeneous problem and to find out the boundary condition. Just I'll give 1 or 2 minutes hint for this, how to proceed. D square, the problem is actually solve d square plus 16 into y. I'm not going to do it on the board for this because, you know, this is only I to explain based on the boundary condition. That's all. E power of minus 3x into cos 4x. And also they given y of pi by 4 equal to 0 and y dash of 0 is equal to 0. They given two values. One is x is equal to pi by 4. X is equal to pi by 4. What's the value y they given? 0. And another value they given. What's another value they given here? For x is equal to 0, y dash of value is 0. Okay. What we are going to do here? First, you find the CF. Actually, writing an auxiliary equation is very easy. M square plus 16. Then what's the root we are expecting? Plus or minus 4i. Okay. And then plus or minus 4i. And then you have to write the complementary function. I'm doing little bit fast because you know very well. C1 into cos 4x plus C2 into sin 4x. Okay. In the next step, you know how to find out pi. Pi for the first term. What's the pi for the first term? 1 by d square plus 16 into e power of minus dx. Here, a is equal to minus 3. It's not a root. It's not a root. Therefore, what's the thing? At replace d by a. What is d by a? A is minus 3 whole square plus 16 into e power of minus dx. Now, what do we get actually? 9 plus 16 is 1 by 25 e power of 3x. E power of minus dx. And then I have to find out pi for the second term. What is the pi for the second term? Pi 1, this one, pi 2 is nothing but 1 by d square plus 16 into cos 4x. Observe, what is the value of a? A is equal to 4, therefore that implies a plus or minus ia is nothing but plus or minus 4i. It's a complex root. It's one of the pair of root of the auxiliary equation. What we are going to do? X divided by f dash. What is f dash? 2d into cos 4x. Because derivative of d square is with respect to d is 2d. This is 0. 1 by d means integrate. What is integration of cos is sine 4x divided by 4. What we get? X sine 4x divided by 8 is the function. What's the next step? We are moving to this thing here. Then you have to write y is equal to cf. Y is equal to cf plus bi. What is cf? Is c1 cos 4x plus c2 sin 4x and then pi1. What is pi1? 1 by 25 to e power of minus 3x and then x into sin 4x divided by 8. You take this as star. This is our general solution, but they are asking to particular solution because they are given some boundary condition. How to proceed? We discussed in the q of x is equal to exponential function, how to find out a particular integral based on the given boundary conditions. They are given two boundary conditions. First, you put, I am giving a hint, try to do it, put x is equal to pi by 4 because they are given y of pi by 4 value. Put x is equal to pi by 4. Observe carefully, put x is equal to pi by 4, what happened? Y of pi by 4. Here, x is equal to pi by 4, 4, 4 cancel cos pi. What is cos pi? Is minus 1. X is equal to pi by 4, yeah, 4x is nothing but 4 into pi by 4 is cancelled. Sin pi is 0, then this is nothing but 1 by 25 e power of, yeah, minus 3 pi by 4, okay? Yes? And then this is also 0. Why? Because put x is equal to pi by 4, 4, 4, sin pi. Even though any product of one of the function is 0 means this is 0. But they given already what is f of pi by 4. What was y of pi by 4? What is y of pi by 4? They given 0. Therefore, that implies what is my c1 is 1 by 25 to e power of minus 3 pi by 4. And next, they given y dash of 0. So first you find out derivative of y. Yeah. Then I have to take star, you find out the derivative. What is y dash? Minus 4 into c1 because derivative of cos is minus sin 4x into derivative of 4x is 4. Derivative of sin is cos of 4x into 4. Now here, what is derivative of e power of minus 3x? Minus 3 into e power of minus 3x. For this, you go for product rule. Derivative of x is 1 plus x into what is derivative of sine 4x is 4 into cos 4x. And then put x is equal to 0. What is y dash of 0? They are given y dash of 0 is 0. Y means y is function of x. Once you substituting the value of x is 0, they are writing y of 0, y dash of 0 like that. Okay. Now, my x is 0, sin 0 is 0, but cos 0 is 1, force into, yeah, plus into minus is minus 3 by 25, e power of 0. What is e power of 0? It's 1. Okay, fine. Plus 1 by 8. These two are 0. Sin 0 is 0, cos 0 is 1, but multiple of x is there, therefore is 0. Therefore, y dash of 0 is also the given 0, that implies C2 is nothing but 3 divided by 25 into 4. Means, what is that actually? The 3 divided by 100 is the C2 answer. Then you write y equals, I have to substitute C1, C2. What is C1? 1 by 25 into e power of minus 3 pi by 4 into cos 4x. Okay. And then C2 is nothing but 3 by 100 into e sin 4x plus 25 e power of minus 3x plus x by 8 into sin 4x is the required particular solution. PS. PS means what? Particular solution. Yeah. Yeah, I'll explain within a few minutes because you know that not necessary to elaborate for this problem. Now, first you have to solve. Up to solving, you know how to proceed. After once you solve, suppose they're given in any problem boundary condition. Now, observe carefully what are the boundary conditions they're given. Based on that, I have to proceed to find out the particular solution. Now, here they're given x is equal to pi by 4. Then I have to put x is equal to pi by 4 in the general solution. We get one value. Again, I have to differentiate the general solution and put x is equal to 0. We get another value. Therefore, this is nothing. There is no unknowns are involved in the solution. That is nothing but particular solution. Because based on the boundary condition, we find out the solution. Means we are taken some constraint, some condition. That solution is nothing but particular solution. Now, I explain how to find out the particular solution. Suppose q of x is exponential function and also trigonometric functions. Before going to solve the problem, I'm requesting the students to go through very carefully for what they're expecting, what they're given in the given problem, what they expect in the problem. Based on that, have to proceed. And also, before going to start to solve the problem, observe carefully in the given problem, which is dependent variable, which is independent variable. Now, we are writing a complementary function based on the independent variable. You can't take always x. You observe carefully what is the independent variable. Suppose they are not mentioned, I told observe right hand side of q of x, what's the variable involved. Based on that, we have to write the complementary function using that variable. Suppose q of x in the right hand side involving the variable is t, we have to write complementary function in terms of t only. Suppose they have any other variable, you have to write it based on that. Keep in mind, writing a complementary function depends upon what type of variable is involved in the right hand side. Suppose they are not mentioned in the form of derivative. It's not mentioned in the form of dy by dx. They are already given in the form of differential operator. Don't confuse. Observe carefully in the right hand side what type of variable involved in q of x. Based on that, you pick the independent variable. Thank you very much. I completed one module, module 2. These are the syllabus they included in 18 deep mat 4-1. And then in the next class, I'm going to take module 5. It's a probability. Okay, bye, see you, and take care.